Thank you everyone for tuning in and welcome to the failure series by the National Incubation Center. The goal here is to present to you leaders of today's market in a different light. Usually all of these people are shown to you with their successes and we ask them about how they achieved what they were able to achieve and what they did right. But today we want to discuss the failures that every entrepreneur, whatever stage they're at with their ideas or with their businesses, they will inevitably run into. And the people we have online for these series have also gone through the same journeys. Today, we have with us Ahmed Khan, who is a founder at Cheetah Logistics. He's been around for many, many years now, and he has been part of the ecosystem for as long as the ecosystem has been there in Pakistan. Ahmed, thank you for coming, and thank you for being here. Shuru karte hain, aap ne apni screen share kar di hai, everybody can see it, so over to you, Ahmed.
Thank you, Amaji. Thank you for having me. It's always a great pleasure to talk about one's failures, considering there's so many of them. Though I did object to the fact that, you know, failures ki baat ki aur sabse pehle everyone thinks of me. So, you know, it goes to show that, you know, what people actually think. But chalo. So I sort of decided to cheat a little and said, yaar, of course, there have been lots of ups and downs. But the idea is to persevere. And you know, every time you're hit with a wall or you fall down, how do you get up or how do you scale that wall and become a better version of yourself and obviously the company that you lead or you work for. So that's the idea today. So I thought I'd talk about some key skills that were acquired through many iterations and through for want of a better word, many failures. So we'll dive straight in. A little bit about myself. I am the founder of Cheetah Logistics, which is the Cheetah app. We're a food delivery service, and now we're becoming a more of a a last mile logistics company where we not only deal with food, but we've got into grocery and pharmacy and do general errand stuff. Before that, I was the founder of the Raaz.pk and Kemu.pk, so I've been sort of involved in e-commerce for a very long time. And now, finally, after many years, we're seeing sort of the tipping point where e-commerce is finally taking off. And even, obviously, in the current scenario with COVID and all, the situation is very different. But even before sort of the COVID crisis hit, there was we'd already started seeing growth of e-commerce and sort of adoption and people getting into it. So that's that's the sort of start of it. I hope everyone is staying safe. I know the lockdown is over, but the threat is still real. So please keep taking precautions. Don't think that this is over. This we have no idea on what this sort of opening of the lockdown is going to hold and what's going to happen. So so please take as much precaution as you can. And obviously the plug-in here is keep using e-commerce to do all your shopping. So yeah, that's that. And in an event, sort of in an attempt to combat this scenario, Cheetah along with Conrad Labs and the Commissioner's Office of Rawalpindi and a few other like-minded friends, we've launched the CoCare app. The CoCare app is a active tracking app, which is sort of our attempt to contribute towards solving this problem that we're in. It's there's no commercial sort of angle here. It is simply meant to track and to make data available to the key stakeholders so that they can use it. So I think it's going to be on the Play Store in a couple of days. So please keep an eye out for it and do download it and do use it as often as possible. It will be very beneficial for everyone. TKG, Zen, I hope you're looking at the chat so that I don't have to, because this,
absolutely, don't worry about it. I'll present it. We'll look at the question.
TKG. So getting right into it, G, Okay, so Cheetah is part of a larger group now. Jabberwock Ventures is the parent company. We have two companies underneath it right now. One is Swift, which is more of a courier, e-parcel, B2C, standard COD operating model. And then obviously we have Cheetah. And we're launching a third venture, which is more in the FMCG distribution management, which you guys will see very soon. So the reason for splitting this out was again, the product of key learning that we had. Cheetah is more point to point, आप ऑर्डर करते हैं, we try to deliver it instantly. And we realized कि यार, when we try to do bulk delivery, which is many to one, it was not possible to do it in the same company. So again, we flipped around a bit. We tried to do it in the same company. It wasn't working out very well. A lot of unhappy customers. So then, as a learning, we decided कि यार, two very different businesses. Let's split them out and try to manage them separately. So again, that's a it's an interesting example of one thing that was failing and it could have brought us down, but we flipped it around and came up with a sort of simple solution to how we can turn this into a real opportunity. And both companies are going very nicely. So we're very glad that we managed to turn this one around. Achha ji. So what does Cheetah do? As I mentioned, we're a multi-category last mile logistics platform. We've coined this term called now commerce. So anything you want instantly, Cheetah is able to deliver. We have a network of vendors which we can leverage to get you any product that you want, which is in these categories. Okay, so let's get into it. So as far as, again, you can argue this that this list isn't very exhaustive, but from what we have learned, that there are sort of two kinds of entrepreneurs that we encounter. One are the real visionaries, right, who come out and do something which no one's done before. And the way I sort of try to explain it is, Kiji, they create the product and then they convince people that there's a need for this product. A great example is the iPod or the iPhone. Okay, people never used to consume content, MP3s on music that way. But Apple came out and said, okay, look, we've come up with this revolutionary product, and they changed the way people live and they changed people's lifestyles with innovation and a product. The other sort of type of entrepreneurs is the hardcore operators who take an existing model and just improve it to an extent that no one has been able to do before. Zoom is a great example of this, right? There was Skype before Zoom, there's Slack, there's so many other communication software, but Zoom has just exploded. And if you look at it, there's nothing that they do particularly differently. The only thing is they just do it better than everyone else, right? It just works so much better and so much nicer. So again, you don't have to be exclusively a member of one club. You can pick a, you can alternate between whatever you want to do. But typically, this is how people tend to fall in. And there's a good way to sort of look at your business as well. Are you doing something completely different, which requires a paradigm shift or a mindset change? Or do you want to just improve on the services that are being offered? I'll talk about this a little more in detail. TKG? Okay, so one of the things that I firmly believe in that, your business, you are an extension of your business, right? So a lot of startups live and die by who the founder is and what the founder does. So one of the things that I really believe is that you should make your stories romantic. Now, again, when I talk about my story, I always start with I was born in a missionary hospital in Saival, a town which is known for its majje and bhense more than anything else, right? So and that always sort of is a good segue into, okay, then things happened and things changed or whatever. But it's always good to add a little bit of romance to your story. It makes you feel a little better. It also resonates with people, and people tend to root for the underdog as well. So that's sort of one tip which I always feel people should practice. Okay, and then despite sort of on top of being romantic, as a startup founder, you have to. Or even someone who works for a startup, you'll find out that you're wearing many hats. It's not as simple as, okay, I am the chief technology officer or I'm the chief financial officer. You'll end up doing a lot of different roles, right? So you have to train yourself in a lot of different things. and you may or you may not have the education or, you know, the job experience for it, but then you have to learn on the job and you know, practice and then improve and eventually perfect all the things that you do. Okay? Tony Stark is a great example, right? Genius, billionaire, playboy, philanthropist. And, you know, and you should keep adding to that list of you know, who you are and what your skill set is. Because it's very important to develop hardcore skills. Again, we'll get into that in more detail later. Achha ji. Then, you know, this sort of whole question of, you know, are entrepreneurs born or, you know, or can they be trained? So that's one of the first, you know, sort of mistakes I made. I always felt, ke nahi yaar, you know, you're a born leader, right? It's an innate skill jo ke aap apne baap dada se ya to inherit karte hain ya Allah ki taraf se aap pe koi meharbani hoti hai, and you know, you can, and either you have it or you don't, right? It's like the eternal debate between Lionel Messi and Cristiano Ronaldo. So you know, me, because I never had the talent, I was always in the Cristiano Ronaldo camp. Yeah, you practice, you improve your fitness and all of that, versus, you know, raw talent, which is, again, a great thing to have, but not everyone has it. So if you don't have the raw talent that, you know, some people are blessed with, there are a lot of skills that you can acquire and, you know, train yourself to be a good leader or a good entrepreneur or a good worker for that matter, right? Some of the key skills are problem solving, you know, analytics. You know, you always have to seek knowledge because people out there, you know, all over the world are doing the same things you're doing. So it's always good to learn from their experience, right? Achha yaar, what is changing the world? Matlab hum jab dekhte hain, kehte hain, achha Swiggy kya kar raha hai? Just Eat kya kar raha hai? You know, Gojek kya kar raha hai? So, you know, there's a lot of, and I'm sure they're looking at us as well, right? Because we're just that good. So some of the key skills that you know, you should look to develop are, you know, being structured, being very agile. Agile is a great skill to have, right? Because things move very fast in this world now. It's not like, you know, I remember hamare zamane mein, you know, when we were younger, to you know, aap fax bhejte the, ya email had just started, right? So you send an email, to agle din jawab aata tha email ka. Ab to, you know, all you do is you send a WhatsApp message, and the minute you get, you see those two blue ticks, to aapka dil phadakne lag jata hai ki nahi, usne do blue tick ho gaye, usne mera message pad liya lekin jawab nahi diya, and you know, and that sort of starts building friction, right? So remember that, you know, you have to move very, very quickly nowadays. The patience level is just non-existent now. Theek hai ji? And having said that, it's not for the faint of heart. Right? If you're not, awesome. Sorry, lost my train of thought there. So yeah, I was saying it's not for the faint of heart, right? So if you feel like, KG, you don't have the perseverance or, you know, sort of the guts to see it through, then it's better to, you know, do something else. Then there's no shame in doing other things. There's lots of you know, well-meaning and good stuff out there that you can do. Not everyone needs to do a startup or, you know, be an entrepreneur. Take care. But remember, it's going to be a grind and it's going to be a battle. So be ready and be prepared. Okay. Take care. So, you know, then there's this whole question of, I get a lot of people asking, oh, give me an idea. What's a great idea? Again, you know, 5 years ago, we used to think your ideas are very important, right? KG, a great idea is enough on its own. But now things have sort of evolved as well, right? Ideas, aajkal mein se koi poochta na ki yaar, what's a good business idea? So I tell them to Google top 10 startups in India or top 10 startups in Indonesia or top 10 startups in Europe. And, you know, in there you have your idea. So ideas are becoming less and less important. The execution has sort of, you know, taken over. And obviously how you execute and what business model you choose, those questions are a lot more important now than, you know, what your basic idea is. Because, you know, people pivot and ideas change and, you know, you start trying to do something and then, you know, you end up doing something else. So again, that's where agile comes. Theek hai ji? And then, yeah, so, you know, building on that idea, you don't really have to have 100% plan ki acha kal main ye karunga parso main ye karunga aur you know 36 din baad main yahan pe pahunchunga. You know, speed to market is very important. So, you know, even if you have half a plan, or in this case 12% of a plan, it's enough, right? Start and your plan will evolve as you go along, right? But be very cognizant of the fact yaar, okay, you should know that your plan is half baked, so you know, constantly try to evolve it and improve on it. Okay, Then comes, you know, then this is the other sort of, you know, learning from a key failure or a key mistake that we made. Yeah, product market fit, Joanna, that is sort of the ethos that we believe in now. Kiji, you know, before you can do anything, you need to have product market fit. Okay? And you should only scale your business when you have product market fit. And until then, you should keep iterating. Kya aapne ye try kiya, nahi market, nahi usko adopt kari. A great example of this is, you know, something like Airlift or Swivel. Okay, you know, they came in, product market fit was immediate, and they scaled like crazy. Okay? But they got product market fit very early on. So until then, you know, you have to constantly evolve. Does the market even want what I'm selling? Otherwise, you need to give the market something that they really do want. Okay? So then the question is, what is product market fit? Okay? So it's sort of like the matrix. No one can be told what the matrix is, right? You have to feel it and you have to be absorbed in it to sort of understand what it is, right? But that's a cop-out answer. The simple answer is, you will know, right? Everything will just click into place and things will take off. Okay, and then is this notion of, you know, at the end of the day, you're trying to sell something or, you know, you're trying to, whether it's a good or a service or a product, right? So you have to be very, again, aware, do people actually want what you're selling? Because, you know, like in this cartoon, well, we all know people who want a swift kick in the butt, so to speak, right? But nobody's going to pay you for it. So you have to be a little careful. You know, what are you trying to monetize and what are you trying to do, right? So unless you're solving a real problem, and sort of the add-on to this is, it should be a problem that you're really passionate about solving. Okay? If it's not very personal, then, you know, it tends to be a half-assed job. Sorry with the language, but, you know, it's very appropriate in this case. Okay. So, and this leads to what product market fit is. Okay. So people are, you know, when people are desperate, when they bring their friends, when, you know, they start banging down your door, you know, that's when you know you have product market fit, right? You know, when people call me up at midnight and saying, maine, you know, Johnny and Jugnu ka burger khana hai, cheetah deliver nahi kar raha, please karwa do. You know, that's when I know, I have product market fit, because people are willing to go the extra mile and, you know, use personal relationships and friendships to get, you know, what I'm selling. So, you know, that's how you know, and that's what product market fit is. Okay, so then, you know, is this sort of interesting idea, how do you get there, right? So one idea is, I want to build a Ferrari. So I'm going to get the wheels, get the chassis, I'm going to get the engine, I'm going to get the body, put it all together, and I have a Ferrari and I'm going to launch. But if you think about it, what does a Ferrari really do, right? Apart from impressing people and, you know, showing off, the main purpose is getting from point A to point B, right? So there are other ways to get from point A to point B, right? You can get a skateboard, then, you know, build a cycle, then a motorcycle, a small car, a big car, and ultimately, you know, get to a Ferrari. The key here is that at every stage of your product evolution, you should have something that you can take to market and people can use. So if you have a product that doesn't work, then there's no point, right? So if you want to follow the second approach, then make sure that at every stage, you have something that works, at least gets the job done, no matter how basic it is. Okay. So these are some examples of you know, how people achieve product market fit, right? You know, if you look at, you know, these examples, you know, okay, discover a new willingness to pay, right? You have Candy Crush and you have Bubble Witch and all those games, right? And Zynga discovered that, you know, once your lives end, people are willing to pay a little bit of money to get more lives, right? So it's a new willingness to pay, which wasn't there before. WhatsApp, right? WhatsApp is a way to offer zero pricing. WhatsApp has no monetization model whatsoever. Yet when it was sold for $18 billion, right? Well, $18 billion is an obscene amount of money for something that has no revenue, right? But it has one of the biggest user bases in the world, and that can be monetized, right? So again, some very basic examples of, you know, what all you can do to, you know, get. The one I really like is Instagram. People had Facebook, people had MySpace. You know, why did Instagram become so popular? And then sort of the evolution of Instagram became TikTok or Snapchat, right? KG, you had all these social media tools which connected people, but all of a sudden, why did Instagram become popular? Why do so many people watch TikTok, right? because it just appeals to a younger demographic. You know, the new generation wants to consume content and data in a very different way and wants to interact in a very different way to what, you know, our generation or, you know, sort of the ones that came in the middle wanted to do and you know, how they wanted to operate. So you can also look for that. Okay, yeah, you should always be willing to experiment, right? Just because something is working nicely, it doesn't mean that you have to sort of stay the course. You can always, you know, improve everything that you're doing. And you know, the great example is, and this is more so with technology. Why does iPhone come up with a new model every year? Why do, you know, Windows come out with a new version every few years, right? Because, you know, it works, but you have to constantly be improving it. Otherwise, you know, you get frozen out of the market. So break things, de-hug, smash, but constantly be improving things. Achha ji, the other sort of thing is, ki how do you look at your business, right? Hamara bhi ek bada challenge tha ki ji, aajkal ke zamane mein, you know, when you look at startups, the one most important thing is top line. So humne bhi jab start kiya, humne bhi yehi kaha ki yaar, top line bus, as long as transactions or revenue grow kar rahe, nothing else matters. But, you know, with the fall, I shouldn't say the fall, but, you know, sort of the failing of Uber's IPO and Lyft's IPO and, you know, the sort of WeWork fiasco, WeWork had a bunch of other problems associated with it as well. The need for profitability is very, you know, became very significant. So when you assess a business, make sure you're looking at the gross margin in the channel, right? You might not capture it day one, but at least you should know, yeah, there's a significant amount of value that you can capture at some point, right? So, and the other thing that you know, is important here is that, you know, when your business is profitable or has high margins, you know, there's a lot of room to make mistakes. I remember maine ek dafa, you know, apne dost ko, I was teaching a class on operations management. So it was all about efficiency and improving things and optimizing or ye wo. So maine usko bulaya class mein as a guest lecturer. Usse jab sawal puche, he was like, nahi, hum ye bhi process nahi follow karte, nahi, hum ye bhi nahi optimize karte. So at the end of the class, maine kaha, yaar, tu pagal hai? Matlab, you know, you follow none of the best practices. You follow none of the theory, right? But how come you drive a Prado and, you know, tere baad defense mein ghar hai, ye wo. Kehte, yaar, margin itna zyada hai ke, you know, ye kuch kiye bagair bhi hum kar sakte hai, right? So, matlab, obviously, matlab, that's, I'm not portraying that as a success story, but, you know, having high margin in your business, means that, you know, there's a lot of room to make mistakes and to learn and you know, to sort of do things a lot more innovatively. So ye cheez zara yaad rakhein ki when you look at a market or when you look at a sector of a market, make sure ki usme margin acha ho aur, you know, usme volume ka potential bahut zyada ho. Okay. You know, the sort of this COVID crisis has taught us, well, we already knew it, but it sort of amplified the fact that you have to make your dollar, you know, go a lot further than it was going, right? So you have to do a lot more with a lot less money. Pehle yehi hota tha ki acha yaar, you know, customer acquisition costs ke koi fark nahi padta as long as customer aa rahe hain. But now you have to be very cognizant of the fact ki yaar, aapka customer acquisition cost zyada na chala jaye, right? So make sure that you can stretch all your resources as far as they can go and don't be wasteful, right? Things have changed very, very quickly. And ab wo zamana hi nahi raha ki yaar aap baith ke, you know, you can be wasteful. But at the same time, you have to prioritize and pick your battles. Don't try to do everything at the same time. You know, look at what will add the most value and do that. Matlab humein ye tendency hoti hai ki yaar shock hai, and you know, I used to do that myself. Yaar ye mujhe bada interesting lag raha hai, ye, you know, isme sabse zyada excitement hai, to ye kar lete hain. But that's not the best way of doing things, right? Look at what will add the most value and what will have the most impact. Achha ji, so this is again, you know, one of the key learnings that we had. Yeah, after a certain scale, you have to change your strategy and you have to change your model. ठीक है? What जब हमने भी चीजें start किया, तो you know जब हम पहले 100 customers को cater कर रहे थे, तो you know हम manually कर सकते थे. उसमें कोई tension नहीं होती थी कि अच्छा यार कोई मसला नहीं, दो call center के लोग बिठाए, ज़्यादा मसला हुआ खुद गाड़ी पे बैठ गए, या Zen, you know, used to work with a Zen को हमने चीते गाड़ी पे बिठाया और कहा कि यार ये cake deliver कर रहा, right? But as you get to scale, that's no longer possible. So, you know, you need to build in automation, you need to build in tools, you need to bring in, you know, a layer of management who can handle these things, right? And you need to have standard processes and SOPs, varna you cannot achieve scale. So at every stage of scale, remember that, you know, you might need to change your strategy and, you know, you might need to shift your paradigm to cater to that level of scale. Achha ji, so this is sort of a growth hacking funnel, right? This is come straight out of theory. It's something that, you know, we use very, very aggressively nowadays. The first sort of part is acquisition. Customer ko aapne engage kar liya. Then you have to get him to buy something. Then you have to get him to rebuy something. And one thing that you know, you will learn very, very quickly is the first time a customer buys, you're probably losing money on that customer. So unless you're retaining him or her and getting them to rebuy, you're probably not going to make money. And sort of the last stage of this is when they refer you to other people. And that's where the real value is. When they ask their friends to come, that's when, you know, you get the maximum benefit out of this funnel. And, you know, this is the button for this talk. Failure will happen. Failure does happen. But remember, the only people who fail are those who try. So don't be afraid of it. You know, here I am celebrating all the things we did wrong and all the things that we learned. So, you know, you should not be afraid to, fail. Because, you know, you were brave enough to try. There are a lot of easier ways to live life. And again, nothing against that. But remember, yaad wohi rehte hain, jo ke, you know, who take a shot. Okay? So please, take your shot. I can read this out, but I'm sure everyone can read it themselves. I couldn't actually type this out in Urdu. Mujhe Urdu ka font nahi pata tha. Okay. So this is sort of a problem solving framework that, you know, we came up with. It's fairly standard. If you Google problem solving, this is the sort of stuff that comes up, right? If you have a problem, you break it down, then you prioritize it, you evaluate all the different options, you have to communicate and syndicate, right? This is a key point of failure. Ke log samajhte hain ki acha yaar maine evaluation kar liya, now let's start executing, right? I think communication is a very important part of this. Everyone should be on board. Everyone should know where you're headed and you know what you're doing. TKG, and then, you know, you have to monitor and iterate. Otherwise, you know, if you're not iterating, you know, you can get stuck very, very quickly. So this part of the puzzle that we've added is the iteration and the pivoting of your business model. TKG, so this, you know, for me happened very late on, right? How do you define success? I never did. I said, "Achha yaar, dekhi jayegi, let's just start." I think you should define success very, very early on. Right? Okay, what do you want to achieve? Do you want to be rich? Do you want to be famous? Bachiyan pasand nahi hai, as in Zain's case. But, you know, whatever it is that works for you, you have to define it early on and you have to sort of go with it. TKG. So yeah, so you know, this is sort of how you do analysis. You know, you figure out who your partners are, internal aap karte ho, you look at competition, you look at your customers, you look at regulation, and you look at, you know, who your suppliers are. So this is what I was talking about, right? Why do people fail, or, you know, what is the biggest cause of, you know, lack of success, right? So you have to build a competitive edge. Either that competitive edge is a network effect, or, you know, you have a very powerful brand, or you build scale, right? So whatever you do, unless you have a competitive edge, you're opening yourself up to competition, and competition is very, very dangerous. So value prop. So what are you selling, right? Do you have better quality? Are you providing convenience? Are you cheap? Are you fast? Whatever your value prop is, you know, these are sort of the four dimensions that you know, you have to operate on and you know, figure it out. And then comes, you know, my favorite part, which is implementation. You figured out and you know, you have to go about implementing it. And these are some of the tools that we use. We use the 80-20 rule, we use the MISI. You know, the why thing is very, very powerful. You keep asking yourself, every time you want to do something, you ask yourself why. Because of this. Then you say why again. So you know, you keep saying why until you're able to satisfy everyone in the room, right? So that's again a very powerful tool that can be used when you're starting to implement. Yeah, this is sort of, you know, an important part that I like, right? So here I am giving you all this advice on, oh, this will work, this will work, this will work. But what I'm not telling you is I did fail and then I realized this, right? So every time, you know, you read something in a book and you read about Facebook success, or you read about Microsoft success, or you read about Uber's success or Kareem's success, remember, it has come after they were successful. अगर कोई आज के दिन आपको बता देना कि यार मैं ये करने लगा हूं और मैं सक्सेसफुल होऊंगा, दैट यू नो इज इम्पॉसिबल. सो जस्ट रिमेम्बर दैट यू नो पीपल विल टेल यू लॉट्स ऑफ स्टफ एंड इट्स इम्पोर्टेंट टू लिसन टू देम एंड टेक एडवाइस, बट nobody knows your business as much as you do, right? Nobody understands the market and nobody's as passionate about it as you are. So ye yaad rakhein ki yaar theek hai, people will give you lots of wisdom like here I am, but at the end of the day it has to be your decision. Theek hai, see what works for you and you know run with that. Tools for survival. Theek hai ji, bahut maar padegi, bahut masle aayenge. Well, I can't even begin to explain ki yaar kya kya what all can go wrong, but it's always good to be lucky. Theek hai, if I were to pick one key skill, it would be to have luck. How do you have luck? Maa ki dua, Allah se, you know, mange, whatever, right? You know, have a four leaf clover, have a lucky horseshoe, rabbit's foot, you know, lucky charm, whatever it is, I don't know, but try to get lucky. Theek hai ji, and you know Thomas Jefferson said it really well, right? The harder you work, the more you iterate, the more luck you have, right? So yes, you know, people talk about it as luck, but it's also a series of, you know, trying harder and again and again and again and not giving up is what leads to luck. And then this network thing is very important, right? So you should have a network of mentors who are experts in the field and you know who you can turn to, kya yaar mar gaya, phas gaya, lut gaya, barbaad ho gaya, you know, and who will just know the answer. ठीक है जी, but it's also important to have a network of peers, people who are going through the exact same thing you are. ठीक है, वो फिर बैठ के जब आप दुख सुख करते हैं, जैसे in my case, you know, बैठ के शाम को शीशा पीते हैं फंसी के साथ, तो you know, यही हो रहा होता है कि अच्छा यार अब क्या करें, अब जिंदगी यहाँ पे पहुंच गई है, you know, so these are people, you know, if your peer group who are going through similar stuff, similar problems, and you know, and it's there's a lot of empathy at play there. I feel it's also important to have a bunch of proteges, right? Because I feel you learn more when you try to teach people, right? Because जब आप लोगों को explain करते हैं और वहाँ से आपको सवाल करते हैं, फिर आपको अपने logic और thought pattern में flaws नजर आने शुरू हो जाते हैं। अच्छा यार मैं बड़ा expert बनता हूँ, बड़ी बकवास करता हूँ। ये तो आगे से इस पहला सवाल किया, मुझे समझ नहीं आया जवाब क्या देना है, right? And then comes the endurance, right? कि यार, you know, you just have to stay at it. बहुत मार पड़ेगी, but you know you cannot give up. अच्छा जी, so this is a little about competition, right? It's always easy to look at conventional wisdom and say, "KR, oh, these people are very successful. I cannot compete with them." ठीक है जी, true in many cases, but I don't know if you guys remember, you know, companies like Agfa or Konica, you know, who used to make film cameras, right? They never adopted the digital sort of क्या कहना चाहिए revolution. ठीक है, where are they now? But your generation has never even heard of them. You guys have never even seen a film camera, right? So remember that, you know, dominant companies fail all the time, and you know this is a statistic to prove it. You know, 500 of the companies, you know, out of the 500 in 1955, only 60 remain. That's a, you know, less than 10. Well, that's about 10% of, you know, companies that are left. So 90% of the companies have failed, and not just failed, they've vanished. They've like gone to zero. Okay. BlackBerry is a great example, right? It was such a phenomenal and dominant force, just like Nokia. Kidhar hai? Nobody's even heard of them, right? Nobody ever wants to hear that brand out there. Theek hai ji? Okay. Having said that, you know, it's always best to avoid competition. So, you know, when you pick a market or you pick a business, try to see ki yaar wahan pe, you know, there's significant barriers to entry and there's not a lot of competition. Because what competition does, it drives your margin down. You hamesha ek dusre ko price karte hain, price down karte hain, theek hai? There's a reason why Pepsi and Coke don't compete on price, theek hai? They've established ki yaar price girai to sabka nuksan hai, right? So they compete on brand and other things. Theek hai ji? Sorry. Okay. So you know, when we started Cheetah, one of the first questions I used to get was, how is Cheetah different from, you know, its competition, right? And I always used to say, yeah, we do the same thing, we'll just do it better, right? That, you know, I learned was a very flawed way of looking at things, and you know, it led to a lot of grief. Okay, so you always have to have a value prop outside, yeah, I will just improve on what everyone else is doing and I'll be better. Okay, you have to do it differently. So remember that. Okay, so you have to have a contrarian opinion. हर कोई अगर एक तरह से कर रहा है यू हैव टू डू थिंग्स डिफरेंटली एंड दैट विल विल लीड अ लॉट मोर सक्सेस देन यू नो जस्ट ट्राइंग टू डू द सेम थिंग एवरीवन इज डूइंग बट बेटर. अच्छा जी, सो हाउ डू यू कंपीट राइट? यू नो यू हैव दिस इविल लुकिंग टेडी बेयर टाइप थिंग ऑन द लेफ्ट व्हिच इज यू नो बिग, इट हैज मोर मनी, इट केम फर्स्ट, एंड यू हैव दिस लिटिल मासूम एनिमल हूज यू नो ट्राइंग टू फाइंड हिज वे इन द वर्ल्ड. So how does this little adorable creature compete with this big evil, you know, teddy bear out there who's obviously very, very vicious? Okay? So the way to do that is if they're bigger, you have to be more efficient. If they have more money, you have to be smarter. Okay? If they came first, you have to evolve very, very quickly. And, you know, size means slow. You know, if you're small, you can be a lot faster. Okay? So build that differentiation, right? And you know, this is what we learned, and this is how we set ourselves apart from our competition. KG, you know, we have a validated business model, we have proven product market fit and large addressable market, and we have a highly passionate and accomplished leadership team, and a highly accomplished team otherwise as well. Okay, so I spoke about this a little earlier, and just to sort of re-emphasize the point, okay, you know, unless people are coming back and bringing their friends, you don't really have a good business, right? If people are not willing to recommend your business, then what do you really have, right? Then they don't really like it. They're here for some other advantage that you're providing. Okay? And this is my biggest pet peeve, right? And this is what we started with, and everyone and their uncle seems to think is a great idea. Okay, yeah, discount kar do, theek hai, dikhna shuru ho jayega. But that's not a real business, right? Agar main 500 rupaye ka zinger leke aapko 400 rupaye mein de deta hu, to usme meri kya skill hai? Matlab langar hi baant raha hu na. मतलब सारे आ जाएंगे, लाइनें लग जाती हैं, राइट? बट दैट्स नॉट व्हाट बिल्ड्स अ बिजनेस. सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी कॉन्शियस ऑफ द फैक्ट कि यार डू आई हैव अ बिजनेस बियॉन्ड डिस्काउंटिंग? अगर मैं आज डिस्काउंटिंग खत्म कर दूं तो व्हाट विल हैपन टू माय बिजनेस, राइट? एंड अगेन यू नो यू लुक एट क्रीम, यू लुक एट उबर, यू लुक एट एयरलिफ्ट, यू लुक एट स्विवल, यू नो दैट्स ऑल दे आर डूइंग. ऑल दे आर डूइंग इज यू नो डिस्काउंटिंग एंड यू नो गेटिंग कस्टमर्स ऑन बोर्ड, राइट? द रियल स्ट्रेंथ इज के हाउ मेनी ऑफ दोस कस्टमर्स आर नॉट ओनली willing to pay full price, but above full price, and for that convenience, right? That is a real test of your business. Achha ji, so how do you do decision making? So this was just a funny slide to put out there, right? Ki ji, you know, you have such a narrow area that you can operate in, right? Ki ji, kya karo? Yahan ye karo, wo karo. So you have to be very careful ki yaar, isko kaise aapne navigate karna hai, theek hai? So there's a very little gray area, and that's where you should operate. Okay? Don't try to do something too big or too small. Just try to hit the sweet spot every single time. A lot harder to do than you know than just talk about. But this is again, you know, one thing that we did. sort of in many ways, one thing that we did wrong. Yeah, we tried to do too much too quickly, and you know, and a lot of it is yaar, achha, sometimes you know you just don't take a decision and you just say achha, yaar, dekhi jayegi. That's not a good idea either. Sometimes, right? You should take active decisions and you know work towards a goal that you set yourself. And this is sort of one of my biggest regrets as well as biggest achievements, right? Okay, I you know building a team is super super important. You cannot do everything yourself, right? So you have to build a team that is diverse and you know that is very very capable. I feel that you know the team that Chita started with was phenomenal, and you know, sort of the failure was that I was unable to retain that team. And you know, and it led to you know a lot of problems later on. So once you get you know once you find the right people, make sure you hold on to them, and you know you create enough value and enough loyalty and you know enough excitement for them to stay with you. A good team goes further than any amount of money, than any amount of you know traction that you have, because they can actually solve problems and build businesses. Okay, and sort of you know just to wind down, just an idea of you know what's going to happen. Okay, it's not easy. Mother, yes, you do sleep like a baby. You wake up every 2 hours and cry. Mother, I can honestly tell you that there are countless times when raat ko you know bada cheekhe maarta hua uthta hai ki oh my god, what have I got myself into? Ye ho gaya hai. How will my business survive? How will I pay my people? And you know, mother, this COVID crisis is a great example of this, right? Yaar, it came out of nowhere, right? All of a sudden, businesses are locked down. There's no way to transact. Restaurants are closed. Shops have closed. E-commerce company, kya karega? Piche principles hi nahi hai. Theek hai? So, you know, you're gonna and there are gonna be a lot of these times where you're gonna question ki main paida hi kyun hua, matlab is duniya mein mujhe Allah ne bheja hi kyun, right? And that's where sort of, you know, where that network will play its part and help you navigate that sort of, you know, those sort of situations. But, you know, sort of the learning here is it's gonna be a tough ride. Theek hai? So be prepared and buckle up. And this is sort of, you know, sort of the ending note. Ki yaar, always try to learn from other people and always try to see ki yaar, logon ne kya galtiyan ki hai, so that you don't have to make the same mistakes over and over again, right? So experience is the teacher of fools, right? So only fools need to learn from experience. Kehte hai na ki yaar, chalo koi nahi, fail ho gaye, but experience the gain kar liya na, matlab baal safed ho gaye hain, theek hai, dhoop mein nahi hue, chalo wisdom hai. But, you know, I'd rather have a full head of black hair and not, you know, having learned from other people's mistakes rather than, speaking of which, I need a haircut terribly. And I was, you know, just talking before everyone joined in, ki yaar, we baal hi kaatte hain aake, matlab itte bure halaat hain. But anyway, so try to learn from other people, read a lot, study different models, because people all over the world are trying to do the same things that you did, right? Matlab, so figure out how they did it and then, you know, localize it into your business. Theek hai ji? And of course, no session is complete without a shameless plug-in. Please do download the Cheetah app and the Swift app and, you know, use it as often as possible. It's a great service and, you know, we're very, very proud of it. And, you know, we hope that, you know, you can enjoy it as well. Okay.
Thank you, Amit. Thank you for the wonderful presentation. So we can move on to the question and answers. We have quite a few, but before we do, we'd like to sort of direct your attention towards sharing some stories, because aapne learnings bahut zyada share kiye hain, but we want to know ki inke piche stories kya hain, jisme the kind of stuff that makes you wake up at night and cry every 2 hours. A couple of slides ago, so aapne mentioned.
Zen, I'd like to add a bit. Sorry, Ahmed, thank you so much. Now, you know, like, I really love all my friends who have the McKinsey background. They really know how to make kick-ass presentations. So, presentation bahut achi, lekin baatein bhi. But yes, koi wo story aisi sunaiye do apni ek do baatein, in which you really, really failed miserably at something, you know, and you believe that this is it. This is it, yeah, and I'm done.
This is it.
And how did you come out of it?
Look, lots of times, right? Okay, so a couple of easy ones, right? So, you know, there was a time when, you know, again, not taking names, but there was, you know, there are times when we're attacked on social media. And sometimes that attack becomes so vicious and so personal. You know, I'm creating a service which will help people. Why can't they understand it? मतलब ये क्यों मुझे गालियां दे रहे हैं? मतलब, you know, क्या हो गया? मैंने क्या ऐसा, मतलब किसकी भैंस चुराई है जो कि मतलब इतने ही मेरे साथ बुरा सलूक हो रहा है, right? And you just want to give up, ठीक है? क्या बस यार, बाहर में गया, ये बाहर में गया, e-commerce बाहर में गया, you know, सब कुछ. I just, you know, I'm just gonna quit and do something else with my life. मतलब मैं जाके वाकई मतलब बकरियां पाल लूंगा और उनका दूध भी बेच सकता हूँ, whatever, right? So there was a particular time when, you know, we were very viciously attacked on social media, and it got so bad that there was literally, you know, I thought that this was it. Yaar, kya hoga? And you know, it came from very powerful quarters, and there was really no way to get out of it, right? And you know what? And it would be great if I could tell you, yaar, ab maine koi jadoo ki chhadi is tarah ghumai and all of a sudden, you know, the problem was solved. Ya maine apne bade bhai ko phone kiya aur usne aake aglon ko phenti laga di and, you know, problem solved. But no, all that happened was ke, you know, news comes in cycles, right? So all you have to do is weather that cycle, and sometimes it's just important to stay quiet. And so what we did was we just never retaliated. Theek hai? The criticism was unfair and it was very targeted, and it was kya kehna chahiye, it was agenda driven, right? So one option was ki yaar, we can go after this, but what we chose was ki nahi yaar, dekhi jayegi bas, masala nikal liya, dua kari aur kya yaar ho jayega. And as luck would have it, you know, sort of the situation pivoted on itself, or, you know, kuch log hame attack kar rahe the, all of a sudden kuch logon ne hame social media pe defend karna shuru kar diya. And, you know, literally within a few hours, this story completely pivoted on its head, and you know, it no longer became about, you know, Cheetah and you know, its service or you know, its practices. It came ki acha aap jo attack kar rahe hain aapka kya agenda hai, theek hai? And again, you know, sometimes it just takes that, just a bit of luck, or you know, a bit of kya kehna chahiye, you know, perseverance ki acha yaar, let's just see how this plays out. So and that's what worked really well for us, right? In that case, another time was ki ji, you know, businesses like ours, and this is the biggest problem people face, right? It's fundraising. Theek hai, we're a cash burning business, which means that at some point money does run out. Theek hai, so you know, we were faced with a situation where we completely ran out of cash, and you know, we were just sitting there ki acha yaar is mahine salary kaise denge, right? Business to band karna padega, there's just no way to operate. So we were sitting there contemplating ki yaar our fundraising efforts have not been successful, there's just no way to you know, survive this. And you know, we were just sitting there, and then you know, sort of we came up with a plan ki acha yaar, you know, we were unable to raise money, so let's try a different approach. So we went out and we said, acha yaar, what are the top VCs in the world, right? Who are the top angel investors? So we made a very comprehensive list, and you know, we started calling people up, cold calls, getting, you know, people to refer us, introductions lead, and you know, and in a period of, you know, 2 weeks, we were able to raise money and to raise a bridge round, and you know, to survive that crisis. And you know, and then things got easier. Okay, once we got sort of the first money in, then other people came along saying, oh yaar, acha, this is a good business, people are investing in this, I want to invest in it too. So sometimes, you know, you have to get lucky. Sometimes you just have to you know, come up with a new approach and say, okay yaar, you know, I've tried knocking on certain doors, let me expand this and let me have a more targeted approach and let me widen the net to see yaar what bites. So and that was very strategic, right? Kaise karna hai, you know, we involved other people. Obviously we had to give up a bit of equity, but you know, that's what's necessary in order to survive sometimes, right? Both are.
अहमद, आप फिर थोड़ा सा जो है ना, मेरा क्वेश्चन डॉज कर दिए, यू मे बी गिल्टी ऑफ दैट, बट वी लाइक टू हियर स्पेसिफिक स्टोरीज अहमद, लाइक फनी स्टफ सारे आई में. सो फेलियर्स में अच्छी बात ये है कि यू कैन लाफ अबाउट स्टफ दैट यू कैन लाफ अबाउट एट दिस पॉइंट इन टाइम, स्टफ स्टफ दैट आई नो अबाउट योर कंपनी, लाइक व्हाई राइडर्स आर अलाउड allowed to go beyond the gate of every person that they deliver to or stuff like
so you know, funny stories, right? Mujhe yaad hai humne jab you know, Kemu start kiya, ya Daraz, actually this is a Daraz story, ki pehli dafa humne you know, rider bheja deliver karne, to cell phone kisi ko deliver karne gaya, aur you know, agla bande ko usne gate pe deliver kiya, usne cell phone liya और यू नो, अंदर चला गया. थोड़ी देर बाद वो बाहर आया, तो राइडर था, उसने कहा कि जी यू नो, यू हैवंट पेड. तो उसने कहा जी किस चीज़ के? मैं कहा जी पैसे. तो उस बंदे ने जेब से बंदूक निकाल ली, राइडर को लगाई, अच्छा कितने पैसे तुम्हारे पास? उससे सारे पैसे ले लिए, एंड ऑल ऑफ अ सडन यू नो, वो बेचारा पैसे भी गए, यू नो, ऑब्वियसली प्रोडक्ट भी गया, एंड दैट्स इट. एंड द गाय वाज जस्ट सो सॉर्ट ऑफ नॉनशैलेंट अबाउट इट, कि अच्छा ठीक है. So इस तरह की भी स्टोरीज होती है. And then, you know, when with Cheetah bhi yehi, you know, we had very similar stories. One was really funny. Ek dafa kisne kaha ki ji, mera aapne pizza pick karna hai aur yahan pe deliver karna hai. To rider gaya, usne pizza ka dabba uthaya aur deliver kiya. Ab wo jab deliver karne gaya, to aglo ne kaha ki ji, aapne kahin nahi jana, aapne idhar khade rehna hai, usko gate ke andar band kar diya. Ab rider bada pareshan ki yaar, ye matlab main to pizza deliver kar raha hu, ye kya story hai? तो टर्नड आउट कि जी, वो जो पिज्जा पिक करने गया था, उस पिज्जा के डब्बे के अंदर 6 लाख रुपया पड़े थे. ठीक है, अब वो अगले बंदों ने उसको बंदूक पे रखा हुआ कि जी क्या, वो पैसे गिन लेंगे, इसने पैसे तो नहीं चोरी किए, ये बेचारा पिज्जा डिलीवर करने गया था. सो या, देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ फन स्टफ. आई थिंक वन ऑफ द की फ्रॉम रीसेंट मेमोरी वॉज, हम बड़ी खुशी खुशी ना बिजनेस चला रहे थे. बिजनेस वाज गोइंग रियली रियली वेल, यू नो, वी हैड गॉन अप टू 200 राइडर्स एंड यू नो, एवरीथिंग वाज सुपर. वन डे हम दफ्तर आए हैं, मतलब 200 राइडर इकट्ठा हुआ हुआ है एंड दे आर रिफ्यूजिंग टू वर्क. मैं शक्ल देख रहा हूँ, मैंने कहा यार ये क्या हुआ है? एंड इट जस्ट टर्नड आउट दे सेड कि जी हमें आप सैलरी दें, हमने नहीं काम किया. एंड यू नो, ईद वाज कमिंग, देयर वर यू नो अ लॉट ऑफ फैक्टर्स एट प्ले. तो मैंने कहा कि यार ये क्या कहानी है? So it turned out कि जी यू नो एंड आई वाज लाइक कि नहीं यू नो मतलब देयर इज समथिंग रॉन्ग वी कांट ऑब्वियसली यू हैव टू पे पीपल बट यू नो दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ एग्रेशन डिडंट मेक सेंस टू मी सो इट टर्नड आउट कि जी जो यू नो आवर कंपटीशन व्हाट दे डन वाज उन्होंने उन 200 के 200 राइडर्स को एट अ सैलरी बम्प सबको हायर कर लिया था एंड दीज राइडर्स वर गोना लीव दे जस्ट वांटेड लास्ट मंथ सैलरी सो दे कुड लीव सो लंबी चौड़ी नेगोशिएशन याद है यू नो लॉन में बैठ गए 100 बंदा बैठा हुआ है जी सर्कल में और जी भाई जो है कौन से खिताब कर रहे हैं थिंकिंग ओह आई गॉट दिस मैं अपनी ब्रेव हार्ट वाली स्पीच करूंगा और यू नो नारा मारूंगा या अली पाकिस्तान जिंदाबाद और एवरीवन विल रैली विद मी बट इट टर्नड आउट ऑल दे वांटेड वाज मनी एंड द मिनट दे गॉट पेड दे वर गॉन सो फ्रॉम यू नो सच अ यू नो ग्रोइंग बिजनेस वी केम टू जीरो लाइक लिटरली ओवरनाइट अब हम बैठे एक दूसरे की शक्ल देख रहे हैं कि अच्छा यार चार राइडर भी नहीं हमारे पास अब क्या करें टर्नड आउट द कंपटीशन वाज यू नो वेरी वेरी अग्रेसिव तो यू नो देयर वाज अ स्लाइड आई पुट इन देयर व्हिच आई स्किम पास बिकॉज़ आई डिडंट वांट टू टेल द स्टोरी बट बिकॉज़ आई हैव बीन कॉर्नर्ड इनटू इट सो हमने क्या किया हमने कहा कि यार देखो राइडर्स जो है ना दे आर सॉर्ट ऑफ द फुट सोल्जर्स राइट दे आर द आर्मी ऑफ द बिजनेस ठीक है तो आर्मी को लीड तो जनरल करता है ना सो हमने कहा कि अच्छा यार कॉम्पिटिशन ने हमारे राइडर्स तोड़े हैं हमने उनका चीफ कमर्शियल ऑफिसर तोड़ लिया हमने कहा जी ठीक है फिर वो राइडर्स भी वापस ले आया और वो उनकी सारी सेल्स की टीम भी ले आया एंड यू नो ऑल ऑफ अ सडन यू नो वी फ्लिप दैट अराउंड एंड यू नो समटाइम्स यू हैव टू यू नो प्ले लिटिल वेल आई शुडंट से डर्टी इट्स फेयर कंपटीशन यू नो ऑल आई वांट टू से इज दैट दे स्टार्टेड इट वी जस्ट रिटेलिएटेड बट यू नो थोड़ा सा इस तरह की भी फनी स्टोरीज हैं कि यार पीपल कम एट यू इन डिफरेंट वेज एंड यू नो यू हैव टू देन play whatever card you have so yeah if someone shoots your foot soldiers you shoot the general
thank you Ahmed those are some fun stories question and answers dete hain fir conclude karte
so main aap baat karati hai
nahi abhi to main karna chah raha tha lekin thoda sa time khatam ho raha hai to bachat ho gayi
I have a question Zain if I can ask fun. And I know there are many that you have to ask. Your Q&A. I can't type there in, so that's why I'm asking. Ahmed, if you were to now look back at this amazing roller coaster ride and journey of yours, what would you think of as one of the main factors that contributed to be the way you are? So, har banda apne aap ko analyze karta hai, all leaders, retrospect mein bahut analyze karte hain ki what has worked so well what's not keep evolving keep adapting not many have known that are the way they were for years to come or the years they were before and the reason they evolve is because they stay at the top so what would you think as one of the fundamental reasons in shaping the way you are what contributed
I started very late, right? I got into this entrepreneurship game when I was around 35 years old, or you know whatever 33, 34. So I think there was a lot of experience, and you know again, baal mere tab bhi safedi the, right? So I would like to think that you know a lot of experience and wisdom sort of came when I started, right? So I had a lot of you know kehte na toolkit meri badi strong thi, aur dusri cheez network bada strong tha. So I think agar aap you know if you want to break it down and you know theorize about it, so the thing that helped me the most in you know overcoming all these problems was one you know I had a problem solving toolkit built over you know my years at PNG or my years at McKinsey or my years at you know running my family business in Pakistan and then you know the wide network that I had to call on you know that I could call on so for example agar mujhe NIC mein koi masla hai to you know theek hai I can just message Fasi and say ki look can you please solve this problem for me koi commissioner office mein masla pad gaya you know we can find an introduction to the commissioner office koi US embassy mein masla pad gaya you know we can find a contact at the US embassy so I think you know these two things sort of really help in you know building or you know
okay.
Again success can't be guaranteed but you know
yeah.
Sort of they improve your chances
okay thank you over to you Zain
fair enough so let's move on to some questions so Shanzi Gilani is asking if so as a startup this is just that is just getting off the ground how do you get the attention of large scale well established companies when partnering with them is imperative to the idea
yes yeah, so it comes down to the first two things that you know that I just said right it's you know, again, funny story is I remember hum ek isi tarah, you know, we were looking to partner with a big company, and you know, humne isi tarah ki fancy presentation leke gaye. 36 reasons the ki yaar, this is why you should work with us, this is why you should work with us. Well, we couldn't even get through the gate. Wo niche jo bichara chhotu sa chuddu sa baitha hua tha, usne kaha dafa ho jao, you know, my first time hi nahi hai tumhare jaise choti companies ke liye, you know, andar hi na ghus, gate se koi andar hi na ghusne the, right? So then what we did was ki yaar, we leveraged a contact, yaar, at least get us a meeting. And when we got the meeting, presentation humne pack ki, usko baste mein dala aur side pe kiya, and literally uske pair hi pad gaya ki yaar dekhen, hum bahut yatim startup hai, hum Pakistan ka ecosystem banana chahte hain, aap bhai nahi hai, please kar lo, right? So sometimes, you know, all this toolkit and all this fancy stuff and, you know, these models and these 36 pages ka Excel sheet, it's all great, and I'm not saying you shouldn't do that. You should definitely do that. But sometimes you just have to connect to people on a human level, and, you know, appeal to their empathy and their sympathy, and just show them that, look, you know, I think one of the best ways to deal with people is that you big them up, right? It's very difficult to go to someone and say, okay, look, main bahut badi cheez hoon, theek hai na? You partner with me, otherwise tumhari khair nahi hai, right? Nobody likes that. So it's always good, you know, to go to people, give them importance, say, okay, look, aap my baap hai, agar aap na aaye, तो हम लुट जाएंगे, हम बर्बाद हो जाएंगे, हमारा कुछ नहीं बनेगा. सो यू नो, सो टू थिंग्स देयर, राइट? वन इज दैट यू नो, यू नीड एन इंट्रोडक्शन और यू नो योर नेटवर्क टू ले द ग्राउंड फॉर यू, राइट? पीपल शुड बी वाउचिंग फॉर यू. उसके बगैर ऑब्वियसली गेट्स अ लिटिल डिफिकल्ट. सो ये चीज हमने बड़ी यू नो, सो दैट इन्वेस्टर्स की जब बात होती है, सो वन ऑफ द की थिंग्स इज, लोग हमेशा पूछते हैं, इफ समवन इंट्रोड्यूसेस अस टू एन इन्वेस्टर, तो वो सबसे पहले पूछता है, तुमने पैसे डाले, राइट? सो इफ द पर्सन इंट्रोड्यूसिंग यू सेज, नहीं यार मैंने नहीं डाले, सो ऑल ऑफ अ सडन उसकी क्रेडिबिलिटी जो है ना, वो यू नो, मतलब अगेन खत्म नहीं हो जाती, बट यू नो, इट्स सॉर्ट ऑफ यू आर ऑन वीकर फुटिंग. सो दैट्स समथिंग दैट वी रियली फेल्ट, कि यार पीपल शुड वाउच फॉर यू एंड पीपल शुड यू नो एंडोर्स यू, एंड दैट मेक्स क्रैकिंग यू नो बिग बिग फिश अ लिटिल इजियर.
Awesome. Thank you. So the next question, it's a good one. What's the golden rule of team building? Is it to hire someone who has passion, or is it someone who can take your dream further?
I don't see how those two things are not the same thing. The thing about team building is, you know, sabse pehle aap Zain ko hire kar le, right? He's probably one of the best team members that, you know, we had at Chite. So that's one good tip. So firstly, you're very lucky to have him on your team. जो है ना कि मतलब वन ऑफ द की थिंग्स दैट आई रेड एंड आई रियली बिलीव्ड इज दैट यू शुड हायर पीपल हु आर स्मार्टर देन यू एंड हु हैव अ स्किल सेट दैट यू डोंट हैव. ठीक है, और लोग इनसिक्योर हो जाते हैं कि नहीं यार मैं बॉस हूँ, अगर मेरे सबॉर्डिनेट्स मेरे से ज्यादा स्मार्ट होंगे या उनको मेरे से ज्यादा आता होगा तो मेरी क्या वैल्यू है. आई थिंक दैट्स जस्ट इनसिक्योरिटी, राइट? यू हैव टू हायर पीपल हु एक्चुअली आपकी वैल्यूज और आपकी विजन जो है ना अलाइंड हो, एंड देन यू नो पैशन कम्स फ्रॉम दैट. And but more, you know, obviously passion is super super important, but just as important is the skill set that you hire. ठीक है, obviously when you hire people you have to compensate them well, otherwise you know they don't come. So you have to figure out a way to compensate them, whether it's through cash, whether it's through equity, whether it's through a role, kya aap kya, you know, you give them a bigger role in the company. So those are the things that you know you need to look for. You know, there's no easy answer to this. You have to look for all these skills, and you have to have people who sort of complement you in ways and are willing to do the things that you're not good at, right? And can do the things that you know that you can't do so well.
Very cool. So I mean, next question, how does an entrepreneur improve his communication? I face a serious challenge to put my point across to my co-founders, and by the time they understand my point, we lose some good time.
So this is what I talked about, right? Ke communication is, theek hai, some people are just naturally gifted, right? Wo aisi baatein karte hain, matlab agar aapne poetry likhani hai to mera ek dost hai, he just, you know, on the spur of the moment, he will give you the best marketing campaigns in a poetic form, right? So some people just have, you know, talent and you know the skill to do that. But you know, you can read, you can learn how to structure arguments. I think one of the key skills that that helps in communication is structuring. ठीक है, आप you know आप जब haphazard तरीके से communicate करने की कोशिश करते हैं ना, so it's very difficult to get the point across. So you should have, okay, you should do this. Why? Bang, 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 and always communicate top down. ठीक है, इसका मतलब ये है कि give the big point first and then expand on them. हम एक point लेते हैं, उसको उसकी 36 घंटे की debate में घुस जाते हैं, फिर दूसरा point लेते हैं. That's not the way to communicate. Communicate the top line message first and then हर point की detail में जाएं. एक लेवल, फिर उसकी पॉइंट की डिटेल में जाए सेकंड लेवल. सो यू नो देयर आर लॉट ऑफ बुक्स एंड देयर आर लॉट ऑफ कोर्सेज ऑन कोर्सेरा एंड यू नो यूडेमी दैट यू नो यू कैन लर्न दैट यू नो यू कैन सॉर्ट ऑफ डू एंड इंप्रूव योर कम्युनिकेशन. बट रिमेंबर टू थिंग्स दैट आर सुपर सुपर इंपॉर्टेंट, अ स्ट्रक्चर एंड कम्युनिकेटिंग टॉप डाउन. बिग मैसेज फर्स्ट एंड देन फिगर आउट कि अच्छा यार उसमें कितनी डिटेल में जाना है.
वेल सेड. सो अहमद, what are the two main things you would do differently if you were to start again? This is for specifically for Chite.
Oh my god. Yaar, the yeah, so again, you know, a funny story is you know, again on failure is, jab humne Chite start kiya na, so obviously we had a founding team and we had a kya kehna chahiye, a group of advisors. So I remember maine, you know, I sort of had, based on my experience, based on my learning, मैंने कहा यार ये चीजें जो है ना ऐसे ऐसे करनी चाहिए, right? For example, multi-category. I was a big fan कि यार multi-category we should do, right? We shouldn't just be a food delivery service. There was, you know, other things around automation कि यार हमें vendor app बनानी चाहिए very very quickly. उस वक्त, you know, sort of our group or you know sort of our leadership team disagreed and they were like, नहीं यार नहीं नहीं तुम focus lose कर रहे हो. Focus, 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 do this. And, you know, me being me, I don't like confrontation and I don't like arguing with people or fighting with people. I'm like, theek hai ji, you know, I'll do it your way. So if I were to do things differently, I would actually very firmly do things the way I thought was best and not listen to, you know, other people. Because at the end of the day, it's, you know, ek bada challenge hota hai ki ji, I'm responsible for the outcome, but I'm not responsible for strategy. Yeah, that cannot work. In my opinion, right? So if you want to make someone, अगर आपने किसी का KPI assign करना है ना कि यार ये तुम्हारा KPI है, then they have to be free to do things their way. Otherwise, you can't hold them responsible for the outcome. So that's, you know, for me sort of the key learning कि यार if I'm responsible, so you know I used to get a lot of criticism for the business not performing, but I used to feel कि यार मेरी strategy नहीं है तो मतलब मुझे क्यों कह रहे हो, right? So ownership ही नहीं थी. So that's one thing that you know I would definitely do things very very differently.
Okay, so someone is saying that e-commerce mein aajkal trend hai customer ko khilao. So and they're claiming most of the deals at Chite do the same. So how do you think a startup can deal with the discount e-commerce that a lot of companies are doing?
Again, I thought I covered that pretty well in the presentation. The key is कि यार आपने कोई value prop देनी है, right? Customers को beyond a discount. Okay, why do you give a discount? You give a discount कि यार वो आपका आपकी service trial करे, right? But once they trial your service, if it's good, then they should come back for free, and not only for free, but they should give you a premium because you're that good. So ये जो part है ना, ठीक है, you can give one discount, but if the customer is only coming back when there's a discount, then there's something wrong with your business. So ये आपने देखना है कि आप value क्या add कर रहे हैं. And you know the three things that you know we learned at Chite was कि अच्छा यार हमने क्या customer को क्या देना है. तो हमने so the three things we came up with was पहली चीज हमने value देनी है. अगर आप restaurant में जाके खाना खाएंगे तो restaurant का बिजली का bill है, उसके waiters हैं, you know उसका मतलब you know this उसका जो भी है rent है. So it's very expensive to run a restaurant. If you do delivery, so your cost is 30-40% less to do delivery. So if we're doing delivery, we're saving the restaurant about 30-40% cost. So uska 10% we can pass on to the customer, right? Because restaurant ko to sasta pad raha hai. So these are the kind of things that you know, you when I say value, this is what I mean. Ki yaar, you know, if you're doing it cheaper, then you should be able to pass on some value. The other good thing about e-commerce is ki you can give an assortment. ठीक है, जब आप यू नो सो फॉर एग्जांपल व्हाई डू मतलब लाहौर का सॉरी इज अ मोर यू नो या इस्लामाबाद के भी देख लें, यू गो टू F7 मर्कज कि अच्छा यार वहां पे 18 रेस्टोरेंट है, मैं वहां चला जाता हूँ and I can eat, right? E-commerce ka ye fayda hai, wo 18 nahi, aap 18,000 restaurant available kar sakte ho. So assortment is a huge part of e-commerce, ki you can offer people a vast variety of pretty much everything that they want. So wo ek bada key element hai. So value, assortment, and the third thing is service. Yaar, it should just be such a good service ki aap ghar baithe, aapne aankhe band karke, aapne app kholi hai, aapne 3 buttons click kiye, khana order ho gaya hai, aur aadhe ghante 45 minutes mein khana aa jana chahiye. So the three things that sort of we built e-commerce pe were value, assortment, and service. Yaar, ye teen cheeze aap customer ko de de, and hopefully you can offset the discounting by giving a great, kehte na, you have to wow the customer. He just has to come back and bring his friends saying, yaar, this service was so good, I'm willing to pay for this service.
Oh, Ahmed, somebody wants to know if Jabberwock Ventures is funding Cheetah and Swift.
Yes, Jabberwock Ventures is funding Cheetah and Swift.
Right. And do you think the field of cargo and transportation is one to go in at this point in time? Do you think it's a good idea? And how would you advise someone to have a startup or build their company in that?
So look, the global supply chain is extremely disrupted, right? ठीक है बहुत बुरे हालात है मतलब क्रॉस बॉर्डर इज बिकम एन इवन बिगर चैलेंज देन इट वाज हम लोग लास्ट माइल करते हैं ये जो कार्गो है इसको मिड माइल कहते हैं राइट मिड माइल में चैलेंज ये होता है कि थोड़ा सा मार्जिन कम होता है बिकॉज़ यू नो दिस बल्क एंड दिस वॉल्यूम आई थिंक दैट मिड माइल इज वेरी राइप फॉर डिस्ट्रप्शन व्हाई बिकॉज़ अगर पाकिस्तान में देखें नोबडी इज यूजिंग टेक्नोलॉजी आप आप यहाँ पे मेथडोलॉजी की एबिलिटी करा दो जो आप बिल्टी कराते हैं आप ट्रक अड्डे पे जाते हैं ट्रक पे चढ़ा देते हैं एंड दैट्स इट देन यू हैव नो विजिबिलिटी अंटिल इट गेट्स टू द अदर एंड ठीक है इफ समवन वर टू बिल्ड सम टेक्नोलॉजी अराउंड दिस कि यार ट्रैकिंग भी है उसमें बिलिंग भी है उसमें सेल्स टैक्स भी है आप उसको यू कैन स्केड्यूल समथिंग ऑन योर ऐप आई थिंक इट्स उबर फ्रेट इज वन ऑफ द हाईएस्ट ग्रोइंग डिविजन्स ऑफ उबर राइट देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ पोटेंशियल इन दैट globally, and I think Pakistan is no different. Everything is, hamara again, Cheetah mein ya Jabberwock mein, my philosophy thi ki yaar, one, you should solve a hard problem, and two, it should be technology driven. Technology gives you the advantage of scale, and obviously tracking and ease of use. But scale is the big advantage that technology gives you. So, aapne jo cheez karni hai, think about how you're going to encapsulate it in technology and deliver it.
Okay, which brings us to super apps. Do you think a super app is a good idea? Something that has services and products and everything under the sun available in the same app?
Yeah, to be honest, I think the jury is still out on that, right? Super app has been successful in China. Super app has been successful in Indonesia. But, nowhere else in the world has super apps really taken off well. So, to be honest, I don't know the answer to that. I just feel ke yahan pe humne jo consumers dekhe hain one thing that we've learned about the Pakistani consumer and again a funny story is ke humne jab pehla focus group kiya to humne logon se kaha ki yaar aap kyun jaate hain khana lete hain whatever aap ghar pe mangwa dete to so the answer we got was ki ji fir hum kya kare sara din for us we have one a lot of time and two this is our only entertainment so our consumers, and that's sort of unfortunately true about the market that we're in. Okay, people value convenience a lot less. That might change with COVID, but what they value is value, right? So ye thoda sa aapko dekhna padega ki ji super apps jo hai, of course they do work and they will work, but I've seen both sides, right? People like, kya khana main food app se order karun, kapde main fashion app se order karun, electronics main, general merchandise app se order karun. At the same time, I've seen the other thing as well. So I think what will lead to success or failure is how well it is executed in this market. So again, it comes down to both ideas are good. Jisko koi banda behtar execute kar dega, implementation behtar kar dega, I think that will be the goal.
You. So, Ahmed, the next question is about forecasting for future and to sort of bring your teammates and your investors on board. So how do you think a startup that isn't really doing much at any point in time in the beginning come up with forecasts and mission statements and all of that to motivate all of these people and to bring them onto your
यार इसका एक क्विक हैक है ठीक है द क्विक हैक इज शुरू में ना यू नेवर सेल योर ओन ट्रैक्शन यू सेल द मार्केट सो हमने जब शुरू में अगेन यू नो मतलब यू कैन एंडोर्स दिस एंड आई थिंक अदर पीपल कैन एज वेल यू सेल द मार्केट देयर आर 220 मिलियन पीपल इन पाकिस्तान 80 मिलियन मिडिल क्लास 50% और 60% ऑफ आवर पॉपुलेशन इज अंडर द एज ऑफ 25 ठीक है जी वी हैव 1% ई कॉमर्स पेनिट्रेशन Okay. So these are the numbers you sell. So you sell, you know, so you don't sell your own self because you're just starting out and you have no numbers. But what you sell is the potential of the market. And then what you add on to that is why you are the best person to capture that market. Okay? And that's how you sort of rope in the investors on those two things. You show them a huge market and then you show them, you know, your team and your skill set and why and your business model and say why you will win this market. So that's sort of the quick hack to that.
Yeah, that's a great answer, Amit. So Amit, demand versus supply, which one do you suggest to work on first? Somebody wants to know.
The answer to this is aapne kabhi daddu agar dechi mein dalne ki koshish ki hai na, so that's sort of the question you're asking. Ek daddu dalenge, you know, you put the lid on. जब आप खोलेंगे लेट टू पुट द सेकंड डड्डू इन तो पहला छलांग मार के बाहर निकल जाएगा राइट सो दिस इज द की प्रॉब्लम राइट के आपने डिमांड बढ़ा दी सप्लाई नहीं है आपको लोग गालियां देंगे आपने डिमांड सप्लाई बढ़ा दी डिमांड नहीं है आपको ये वाले लोग गालियां देंगे सो यू नो मतलब आई एम गोना कॉप आउट ऑन दिस वन एंड से कि यार बैलेंस दोनों को साथ साथ लेके चले सब भाई भाई हैं बट यू नो sort of the theoretical answer to this is you always have to build supply first and then build demand because agar demand aage aur supply na hona there's little recovery from that there you know supply is usually a lot more patient than demand is
okay. So Amit, what resources or what methodologies would you suggest to someone who wants to understand pain points of consumers in Pakistan someone who wants to get customer insights without having a business
yaar just post something on facebook log itne vele hain aapko aise aise comments denge you know there are a few things that cricket ho gayi politics ho gayi religion ho gayi and now e-commerce everyone's an expert right there are a few forums you know startup founders ke hain or just generally anything you post on facebook you get a crazy amount of responses so yeah it's not too difficult with social media or better yet post a tiktok video man matlab you'll just get a phenomenal response on that
theek hai so what is the one piece of practical advice you would give to all startup CEOs who are just starting out
don't मतलब यू नो लाई डाउन टेक एन एस्पिरिन अंटिल द फीलिंग पासेस नहीं यार यू नो आई थिंक दिस होल प्रेजेंटेशन वाज अबाउट एडवाइस राइट सो आई डोंट वांट टू सिंगल एनी वन थिंग आउट यू नो फील फ्री टू गो ओवर द प्रेजेंटेशन अगेन एंड यू नो टेक द लर्निंग दैट यू वांट टेक व्हाट्स रेलेवेंट टू यू एंड यू नो अप्लाई इट बट द वन थिंग इज कि यार इट्स गोना बी टफ सो यू हैव टू हैव परसेवेरेंस राइट उसके बगैर and you know, I'm going to keep coming back to the network. Yaar, you should have a network of mentors, but you should also have a network of peers, jinke saath aap shaam ko baith ke apne dukh sukh kar sake, and you know who can help you survive this, and obviously who can open doors for you. Okay, because you know we're in a market which is very relationship driven, right? Everyone knows everyone. It's not, but the things don't work as well here. Ki ji, acha aap line mein khade hoke, matlab you know you can't get it done. ठीक है there's always someone who knows someone jo ke line kaat ke sabse aage ja ke khada ho jayega and you know he'll beat you to it so so that network is very very important so go to the right schools make the right friends you know hang out with the right places
the perseverance come on success part does help with the other thing
so you know you should have one kid who goes into the army one kid who goes into the bureaucracy one who's a businessman and you know you'll be set
On those wise words, we will wrap up today's session. Emmett, thank you so much for being here. This was a lot of fun.
Thank you so much.
And thank you for taking the time, G. This was really great. Invaluable learnings aapne share ki sabke saath, for which I and the National Incubation Center both are extremely happy and grateful. Yeah,
thank you very much. This was a real pleasure, as always. You know, seeing familiar faces. Obviously, I can't see the participants, but I recognize the name Shanze Gilani. So, you know, hello. And, you know, thank you all for, you know, listening in, and, you know, best of luck. And we're always available, right? If you need any further help or just someone to talk to, or, you know, please reach out. We're on social media. So.
Thank you,
Thank you. Yeah, I also like to thank you, Ahmed, for your valuable time. बहुत मजा आया आपकी candid गुफ्तगु और insights and the pearls of wisdom that you shared. Really liked this session. Thank you, Zain, for hosting an incredible session.
Thank you. Take care, guys. Take care. And thank you all the people who came in and signed in and viewed all of this. Take care, guys. Bye bye.